So with that knowledge, in some sense, strings in C are extremely simple, in that a string in C is really just an array of characters. And in particular, they are what we call null terminated, which means that they end with this null value at the end. So here we have some syntax that looks very similar to the declarations that we had before for integer arrays. And so now we can just use a string to initialize this array of characters. And in both of these, we would get something that in memory looks like this, where we have an array of characters, and then we have a pointer or an alias that essentially points to that array in memory. So there are several different places that a string can be located in memory. So there is so one way to create and initialize strings is to put them either on the stack or in some static region. And so if you have a string that you want to initialize with something that you know the value of while you're coding your program, you can declare it this way. And that this means that you don't have to specify an explicit size. It'll just calculate the size that you need to store the string that you're giving it. If you don't know sort of what kind of what text you want to store in a string, you can just declare it and give it a size, and then it'll just be sort of uninitialized until you're ready to use it. And then if you perhaps have a size that you don't know in advance, then you can allocate space for a string on the heap using malloc. So here we're using a specific size, but this could be a variable. And this would give you enough space on the heap to store this. So this would be 11 minus 1 characters, right? Because we lose one character to the null character, which always terminates the string. So strings are not built-in types, right? They're just arrays of characters, and so that means that we're going to need to use functions to manipulate strings rather than operators like you would in Java. So there are a variety of functions that you can use to manipulate strings in C, and so you should spend some time reading the documentation on these functions to learn how to use them, and we will use them throughout the semester, so you'll become more comfortable with this as we go along. And this is a good point at which to emphasize one of the major themes that we'll see in this course, which is that information is bits, so raw data, plus context, which is information about how to interpret that data. So if you were to look at strings in C, by default they are encoded using something called ASCII encoding. We're going to return to this later on and study it in more detail. But basically, the values that are stored on disk are really just numbers. Each byte is one character, and it has, you know, the value from here in this table we have from 0 up to 127, but there are encodings for up to 255 as well. And so this is the decimal number, this is its hexadecimal equivalent, and then this is what the actual meaning of that code is. So you can see that 0 is the null character. There are some symbols over here, we have numbers here. Notice that you know, the numbers are encoded using numbers that are different than the numbers, right? So the number, the character 3, so the digit 3 in a string is encoded using the number 51. And then we have both uppercase and lowercase letters. So for instance, an uppercase A is stored using the number 65, and the lowercase A is stored using the number 97. And so these are the values that are stored under the hood. And so, you know, if you didn't know that you were looking at a string, it would just look like a string. It would just look like an array of numbers. And so that's why it's really important to consider the types, because the types give you context. If you don't know you're looking at a string, it's just going to look like a bunch of numbers.